Alright, so today I'm going to be walking you guys through my Grenadier support build. It utilizes four-piece final measure, the shortbow championship knee pads, a variable chest piece, and a variety of guns to augment the build and support the composition. It can deal a lot of burst damage, it has a very off-meta style of gameplay, and it's something I consider to be quite fun. So I'm going to walk you through all of my gear pieces, all of my choices for each gear piece, all of my different stat points, my weapons, my skills, my talents, etc., and then I'll kick it over to some gameplay. To start off with, we are going to talk about the shortbow championship knee pads as they are integral to the build itself. Now, on these pads, I have gotten a fairly bad roll, but it will serve the purposes that I need. The talent is the most important part here. Shortbow championship pads reduce the fuse time on grenades, all grenades across the board, by 0.2 seconds. This allows you to throw frag grenades, which instantly detonate. You can proc chain reaction very easily and deal a lot of damage to enemy teams or enemy NPCs and stagger them, etc., on cue. It's a very, very fun support style build with burst damage capabilities, and it's something I would advise everyone pick up and try out, even though it is very off meta. For major attributes here, I have 1173 stamina. I would prefer something much higher, but again, the talent is the most important part. For a major attribute, I have armor. This is very critical. It is something you're going to roll across the board. And for minor attributes, I have increased kill XP, shock resistance, and bleed resistance. Now, the most important thing in the minor attribute category would be enemy armor damage. I was not lucky enough to roll that, but shock resistance is actually very helpful for the build as well, and I'm not really going to complain about that part. Moving on, we're going to talk about the actual composition of the build after we talked about the main core component, which is the shortbow knee pads. You're going to run two-piece stamina, two-piece firearms, and one-piece electronics to unlock all of your different gun talents. Next up, we have the Barrett's Bulletproof Vest, but it is important to note that this is not integral to the build. This is another very low RNG chance item. This is something that is not likely to drop, and you do not need this to make the build function. The only named piece that you actually need is the shortbow championship knee pads. Now, since I do have the vest, I will be talking about it, and this is what I'm going to run in my build composition, but you can easily switch it out for something like Vigorous and or Rapid. Rapid is very, very powerful. I would advise this for something, you know, in a support style of role if you want to have your heal skills more frequently. And then Vigorous is a more selfish talent now because it allows you to receive overheal from all your healing skills and then receive an overheal from any allied healing skills, but it does not grant you the ability to overheal your allies. It's something that has been changed a little bit and is still very valuable, but valuable in a different capacity. So again, I would advise switching out the Barrett's chest piece if you don't have one for Vigorous or Rapid. Both are very, very powerful with this build. But since I do have the Barrett's Bulletproof Vest, I will talk about this as part of my build since it is incorporated into what I'm showcasing now, and it does fit very well with my stat points. I have a decent firearms roll, 1195. As you can see here, the talent is no skills on cooldown, increases skill power by 10%. That interacts very, very well with the shield, considering that the shield is not on cooldown while it is active in front of you. One skill on cooldown increases damage by 5%. That pairs very well with booster shot and will be active a significant chunk of the time. And then two skills on cooldown increases armor by 10%. Very valuable for allowing you to have increased survivability between when your shield drops and when it comes back online after the cooldown has deteriorated. For major attributes, I have health and armor. That's the most potent combination for increasing toughness, and toughness is very valuable now, especially in PvP, but also in PvE because the NPCs do hit quite hard. And then for minor attributes, it's a quality of life thing. You want some ammo capacity. Whether it be on your chest piece, your backpack, or both, ammo capacity is very valuable, especially in situations where there's long, drawn-out encounters. We're going to be dishing a lot of damage, taking a lot of damage, and you don't want to run out of ammunition during that time. So this is a very good chest piece, but again, you can switch it out for another one, namely Vigorous and Rapid, but it does fulfill my purposes. Now to talk about the actual gear set pieces, since we are utilizing a four-piece talent, and that is the final measure gear set. For this mask, what I have opted to run is 1253 stamina. That's a great roll. I'm really happy that I got that. In the major attribute slot, I would recommend skill power. That's great for increasing the amount of healing that you do, increasing your shield's toughness, etc. And then I have 9% increased enemy armor damage in the minor attribute slot. That is fantastic as it now translates directly into PvP. There's not a much better combination that you can be running for this mask. You know, the main stats are interchangeable. You don't have to run stamina in your mask slot in particular, as long as you maintain the 2 and 2 and 1 ratio of 2 piece of stamina and 2 piece of firearms and 1 piece of electronics. But this mask is something that is well rolled. I do prefer it in this build. Skill power and enemy armor damage are what I would recommend, and that is something that is going to perform very well for you across the board in both PvE and PvP. Next up, we have our final measure backpack. Now, I have opted to run electronics here. This allows me, in tandem with my different gear mods, to unlock all of my different gun talents, both talented and cool-headed, which I'll talk about in a moment. But this has a major attribute of armor, a well-rolled electronics stat point, and a minor attribute of ammo capacity. Since I do have ammo capacity in both my backpack and my chest piece, I am hardly ever going to run out of ammo in any situation. And since I do have armor, that increases my toughness drastically. I would recommend rolling armor here, but a passable exchange would be skill power. You can change out armor for skill power if you want to have increased healing, if you're okay with sacrificing a little bit of toughness and having a little bit more utility for your team. This is a very good backpack, and I'll talk about my performance mods, etc. later on in the video. Next up, we have our final measure gloves. Now, on these gloves, I have opted to run critical hit chance, pistol damage, and damage to elite. Now, this is for the very specific reason that I will most of the time be operating from behind my shield and using my pistol with a specific talent on it, cool-headed. Now, I also have a decent roll on firearms here, and overall, these are going to augment the build very, very nicely. However, you do not have to roll these exact major attributes or this exact main stat. Again, it is variable. You can switch out damage to elites if you'd like to. If you do plan on using something other than the shield and using something like your Liberator or an assault rifle, which I'll talk about again in a moment, you can switch out pistol damage for that weapon damage type. It will serve you just as well. If you don't want to be on the front lines tanking all the damage and you want to be farther back, you know, firing off skills and, you know, lobbing grenades from there, it will function just as well to have different major attributes. Last up for gear, we have our final measure holster. Now, this is a very straightforward item to get. There's not a lot of variability. You want the highest possible main stats in all three categories. Ideally, something like 1250 across the board, but 1240, 1261, and 1225 will serve my purposes perfectly. For a major attribute, you always want armor, and this is one of the items that you're never really going to change. Holsters are very easy to acquire, and it's very easy to tell if they are good or not in terms of when it comes to building around a gear set. Next up, we have our weapons, starting with the Liberator. Now, I have opted to run this named item here, and it is available for purchase at the Hub Vendor down next to the Survival DLC, down right before you enter the Underground. It does cost a significant chunk of Phoenix credits, but I believe it to be worth it. Has great enemy armor damage, has great RPM, has great base damage scaling, and then the intrinsic built-in talents are competent and talented, and I've re-rolled the center talent to determined. All three of these talents are capable of being activated due to my semi-hybrid nature. Competent pairs very well with Booster Shot. Determined helps me decrease my cooldowns if I do end up using this gun and hitting from the back lines and not on the front lines with my shield. And Talented, every time I get a skill, I increase my skill power by a significant portion for a long duration. That means that I can support my team even further. Since I am fulfilling that sort of hybrid support composition, while I can deal burst damage, I am also dishing out heals, and I'm doing a lot of things to keep my squad going, you know, behind the scenes, keep them active while pushing against enemy squads or, you know, keeping them alive against NPCs. Next up, we have my secondary, which is an MP7. This is not critical to the build at all. You can run anything that you want in this slot. I have opted for something with very high RPM, 35% critical hit damage. That's awesome. As soon as my shield is down, I can use this to actually burst down enemy combatants, whether it be an NPC or an enemy agent. The base damage is quite low, actually, but Brutal, Destructive, and Responsive are fantastic talents. This is something that I will be using in burst damage situations where I don't have my shield, I can't fulfill my normal role responsibilities, and I want to actually have relevant gun DPS. This is going to be a fantastic weapon for that. Now, that being said, you can swap out to anything else. You can run a shotgun, you can run a sniper rifle. It is completely user's preference. This is not integral in any way, shape, or form to the build itself. Next up, we have the most important weapon in the build, and that is the 93R. You're going to be using this weapon more often than any other, and it actually needs a specific talent to function the right way. That talent is going to be Cool-Headed. Performing a headshot reduces all skill cooldowns by 5%. This is very valuable, and since the 93R is a burst fire, 3-round burst, semi-automatic pistol with a decent mag size and a very high RPM, you're going to be able to reduce your skill cooldowns if you are accurate and landing your headshots by a significant margin at will. The second talent I have opted to run, since I can activate it, is Talented. That means that I don't need to switch to the Liberator in order to get a kill. I can still increase my skill power with my shield up by a huge margin for a long duration. This is very valuable for supporting my team, and this is the most important weapon that you should be choosing when you are running this build composition, when you are trying to fulfill this role responsibility of a Grenadier. Talented and Cool-Headed are very, very good to opt for. Next up, we have all of our gear mods. Now, in this situation, I have opted to run electronics with armor in every single slot, and what that results in is higher skill power for more utility for my team, higher toughness because of the armor rolls on the actual gear mods, and the ability to unlock all of my different gun talents through the acquisition of more main stat. Now, you can switch this out if you don't really care about certain talents. You can switch this out for stamina with armor or even firearms with armor if you want to deal more damage or soak more damage, but I have opted for electronics in this case. And then for all of my performance mods, we have first aid ally heal, ballistic shield, damage resilience, Down here in this holster, we have another ballistic shield damage resilience, and then in the knee pads, we have ballistic shield damage. Now, I would advise running a lot of first aid ally heal. This has a drastic impact on how well you can support your team, but ballistic shield damage and ballistic shield damage resilience will either make you deal more damage or soak more damage, and both ways will also contribute to the value of the build. Last up, in terms of gear, we have our actual weapon mods. Now, it's important to note that since you are not the primary weapon DPS character in your squad, or you're not, you know, composing a build that revolves around primary weapon DPS, you can mod the guns however you want. That being said, I would strongly recommend extended magazines with increased mag size of over 100% for both weapons. That's very valuable. For an optic, I don't actually have one here, but you can run something with headshot damage. That's very, very powerful. For a muzzle brake, a primary attribute of headshot damage, again, is going to increase your DPS, your value, and your burst potential. And for an underbarrel, I would actually opt for something like reload speed if I had one, but currently critical hit damage is going to serve my purposes fine. For my MP7, it's kind of the same story. You're going to run with an extended magazine. You're going to look for something. You can't actually put an optic on an MP7 that has headshot damage, but you're going to look for something with, you know, a minor attribute of headshot damage instead of a major attribute. Critical hit chance, also very good. For your muzzle, you want something with critical hit chance or headshot damage again. And your underbarrel, critical hit damage is very, very good and very potent, as well as reload speed. However, none of these are integral to the build. You can switch these out at will. You can mod your gun for whatever feels good for you, whatever feels organic in combat. Go ahead and throw those modifications on the gun, and it's going to serve your purposes just fine. For the pistol, I have opted to run something with stability because the 93R has very, very high recoil. Especially with the 3-round burst mechanic, the gun will kick very high, and it is slightly augmented by the fact that you're going to be running assault shield, which I'll talk about in a moment. But stability, accuracy, and headshot damage is an ideal modifier for your 93R pistol. For my skills, I have opted to run booster shot, which is very valuable for increasing both damage resistance and damage for a short period of time, increases your burst potential, and just aids the utility of the build overall. However, if you want increased personal survivability, you can opt for overdose, absolutely. It's a very efficient skill. And if you want to have increased team utility, you can opt for defibrillator with a very high ally heal number, as you can see there, before being augmented by talented. All three of these heal options are viable for different styles of gameplay, and it's really user's preference what you want to go with. Moving on after that, we do have the assault shield on the ballistic shield modifier. Now, what this allows for is the weapon has increased damage, which means your pistol is more relevant. You have knockback for dealing with NPCs. You have accuracy to keep the reticle on target more often, and faster reload speed for dishing more damage more frequently. This is a very valuable modifier, especially with the 93R, and I would advise running it. That being said, if you want to be more tanky and don't really care about, you know, recoil, landing cool-headed shots, or increased damage, you can equip reactive targeting. This is very helpful in a solo play standpoint because what you're going to have is the enemies pulsing themselves. It does have increased health and toughness overall, as you can see, 641,000 versus 1.2 million in the health standpoint of the ballistic shield. So it is very, very strong. And then someone that wants to have increased survivability, you can roll with kinetic breaker. It does help quite a bit, but I would recommend assault shield or reactive targeting in pretty much every single situation. Next up, we have our talents. Now, these are not something that you're going to want to change. These all have a very specific reason for being active, and they're all very valuable to the build. Starting with critical save, this is an essential component of any build. It allows you to maintain significantly increased toughness whenever you get to low health and pop a medkit. Very valuable across the board. Then we have combat medic. Now, it's important to note that this procs on proxies within 20 meters by 40%, and that means your ballistic shield as well. Anyone in your group, both you and your teammates that are running combat medic, will be able to heal your ballistic shield for 40% of its max health every time they pop a medkit. So that is very, very potent, especially in PvP. And then for the other two talents, we have Demolition Expert, kill a hostile with an explosion to increase explosion damage by 20% for 15 seconds. The way the grenades work now, the amount of, you know, base damage and the scaling that they have will allow them to kill a downed agent with one grenade. Since you are going to be using Final Measure, defusing grenades, as well as dishing them back out, you are going to frequently proc Demolition Expert. And then to increase the damage of your next consecutive grenades for 15 seconds by 20% is going to be invaluable and allow you to actually almost one-shot some enemy agents with a grenade at times. Moving on to Chain Reaction, this is the other essential Demolition Grenadier talent. We have damage multiple hostiles with an explosion to apply 20% more damage from the blast. This is very easy to do. A lot of times enemy squads are going to be grouped up trying to triage each other, you know, using heals on each other, and you're going to be able to land a grenade on more than one target, upwards of 2 to 3, possibly sometimes even 4. Now, when you do that, 20% increased damage on top of an already very high base number and multiplier because of the grenades and the fact that it is exotic damage and not a lot of people have specced into EDR. is going to be very valuable to the build. And when you do have Chain Reaction and Demolition Expert both active at the same time and are able to throw a frag grenade, that can actually almost sometimes even wipe an entire enemy team. It is very, very potent. Something I would strongly advise running. This is a really fun style of gameplay and a very fun build overall. And I'm going to kick it over to some gameplay right now and talk about how Final Measure functions, how the shield functions, and why the build, you know, works the way that it does in a support capacity. Okay, so a few things to note about Final Measure in general is that you can absorb allied grenades. Not only that, you can absorb grenades while they are in midair. As you can see there, I absorbed a grenade before the actual grenade itself got over to the area it was going to land. You can absorb any reticle that you see on the ground every 8 seconds, which is extremely potent. And you can absorb allied and your own grenades. So as you can see here, my ally is feeding me grenades. This is a mechanic you can take advantage of. Since you are running these shortbow knee pads, you can actually instantly detonate your grenades when you throw them, nearly instantly, and allow you to land them much more reliably on enemy agents in particular, as well as enemy NPCs. They won't have time to dodge out of the way. So what your squad can do before any encounter, anytime there's a lull in combat, is they can feed you a lot of grenades and prep for that encounter. Another thing to note is that Final Measure does disable enemy mortars. Not only does it disable enemy NPC mortars and shells, it will also stop the enemy APC and the enemy mortars in both Clear Sky and in Falcon Lost, and it is very valuable for progressing a team through those missions. As you can see here, when someone is out of position, I can disable the enemy mortar, resulting in me taking less damage. When he does go down, I have the ballistic shield, I can absorb a multitude of damage, I can stay alive in a lot of situations, and it has a lot of utility. This is something that does directly translate from PvP to PvE and has a lot of value, especially in incursions and against enemies with the shortbow knee pads that you would need to get some status effects on, some CC, before they dodge out of the way. That will allow you to with the instant detonation time. In PvP, since a lot of people, again, do group up and run very close to their allies for triage, etc., and a lot of the fights now in PvP in the Dark Zone are positional. There's something that, you know, is based on advantages, you know, where you stand, where your group is fighting from. This build is going to allow you to instantly detonate a lot of things on the enemy and control their position from far back if you need to. You can also opt to switch out the ballistic shield if you really want to and sit even further back and use your liberator to support, as well as run a sticky bomb and then dish even more ranged explosive damage. Take advantage of your talents in an even greater capacity. And it's a style of gameplay that I don't see very often. I think in my entire division experience up till now in 1.5, I've only encountered one person outside of myself that was running this build or something even similar, or even running Final Measure, and it is something that's very strong, especially in PvP with a lot of people running grenades, you know, using their frag grenades to devastating effect and being able to do you know, a lot of kiting and positional stuff while leading you around a corner, dropping a frag grenade on you. To have this Final Measure build to help a squad, to help your team, is actually really, really cool and very, very valuable and effective. When they are grouped up in a choke point, you are able to drop down grenades. We can drop this enemy agent that comes behind us. And when you do land the grenade on multiple people, that's a huge amount of burst. You're talking well over 70 to 90,000 damage on all the enemy team members at once. And then also a stagger and a bleed associated with that. This is a very strong positional build. You do have to make sure that you're keeping the shield between you and the enemy. That is integral. But every time the shield does get low, you can pop combat medic. You can pop, you know, a medkit, or your allies can regenerate a large chunk of health. And in the end, you're going to be able to control the pacing of the fight. You're going to be able to eat the grenades that they throw and throw them right back. Every time they do throw a grenade, it's very important to know that you will get a grenade of that same type. If they throw an incendiary grenade, you will also receive an incendiary grenade, which means at the beginning of team fighting encounters, when the enemy are throwing all of their best grenades, you are able to absorb those and then use them for the rest of the fight against them. Something that's very fun. Again, it's not going to break the metagame. It's not something you're going to see all the time, but it's super cool. It's off meta. It's different. It's refreshing. And it's something I will always try and opt to use from here on out in a squad if we, you know, encounter enemy teams using grenades the way that a lot of them like to do. So that's going to wrap it up, guys. Thank you for listening. Thank you for watching. If you want to support the channel, please check out the links below. And as always, have a nice night.